JFT, just fair and direct.
Good morning, everyone, and welcome to JFT's daily market review for March the 2nd. I am Charalambos Pissouros, senior market analyst here at JFT, and I will talk about yesterday's main market movers, what's my opinion moving ahead, what are today's important events, and how they could affect the markets. But before we start, let's read our disclaimer. The content we produce does not constitute investment advice or investment recommendation, should not be considered as such, and does not in any way constitute an invitation to acquire any financial instrument or product. I will leave you a few seconds to read the rest, and then we will jump into our analysis. Okay, the US dollar traded higher against the majority of the other G10 currencies on Monday and during the Asian session Tuesday. It gained the most versus CHF, GBP and the euro in that order, while it lost some ground only against NOK and CAD. The greenback was found virtually unchanged versus the Aussie. Now, the strengthening of the greenback suggests that markets continue trading in a risk-off fashion on Monday and today in Asia. However, the weakening of the safe haven franc points otherwise. Thus, in order to get a clearer picture with regards to the broader market sentiment, we prefer to turn our gaze to the equity world. Here, major EU and US indices were a sea of green, with the main gainer being Nasdaq, which enjoyed its best trading session in a month. However, market sentiment deteriorated again during the Asian session today, with Japan's Nikkei 225 and China Shanghai Composite sliding 0.86 and 1.21% respectively. The rebound in EU and US stocks coincided with a pullback in bond yields, and it may have been the result of optimism over the coronavirus vaccination programs and the large US fiscal stimulus package. Johnson & Johnson began shipping its single-dose vaccine after it was authorized by the US over the weekend, while President Biden's $1.9 trillion relief package passed through the House of Representatives. The bill now moves to the Senate. What may have also helped market sentiment is the upside revisions in the market manufacturing PMIs from the Eurozone, the UK and the US, as well as the fact that the US ISM manufacturing index increased to a 3-year high. However, the joy did not last for long, with yields rebounding and equities pulling back during the Asian session today. It seems that investors are still concerned that the economic recovery will lead to higher inflation, which may in turn lead to central banks scaling back their monetary policy accommodation, despite several central bank officials, including Fed Chair Powell, noting that policy is likely to stay loose in the next few years. This means that yields may continue drifting higher for a while, something that may weigh further on equities, but we don't expect this to last for long. Eventually, investors may digest the idea that central banks will not begin normalization anytime soon, which combined with the progress in the COVID vaccination race and the US fiscal stimulus package may allow equities to rebound the trend north again. After all, we got a first taste of that during the EU and US sessions yesterday. Now, as for today, the items on the economic agenda that may attract special interest are Eurozone CPIs for February and Canada's GDP for December and the fourth quarter as a whole. Kicking off with Eurozone's numbers, the headline CPI rate is forecast to have ticked up to 1% from 0.9% year over year, but the HICP excluding energy and food rate is anticipated to have declined to 1.1% from 1.4% year over year. Despite the lockdown measures around the Eurozone, at the press conference following the latest ECB meeting, President Lagarde said that the downside risks to the economic outlook are now less pronounced, making investors skeptical over further easing. The minutes of that meeting revealed that other members shared Lagarde's view, and thus we don't expect a slowdown in core inflation to spark speculation over more stimulus by the ECB, especially after the PMIs for February came in better than their January prints. Now passing the ball to Canada, December's month-over-month rate is expected to have declined to 0.3% from 0.7%, while no forecast is currently available for the quarter-over-quarter rate. At its prior meeting, the Bank of Canada decided to keep interest rates and the pace of its QE purchases unchanged, disappointing those expecting a small cut or even an increase in quantitative easing. Officials also noted that as the Governing Council gains confidence in the strength of the recovery, the pace of net purchases of Government of Canada bonds will be adjusted as required, which suggests that the next policy step for Bank of Canada may be tapering quantitative easing. However, the employment report for January disappointed, with the unemployment rate rising to 9.4% from 8.9%, and the net change in employment showing that the economy has lost 212,800 jobs. What's more, although the CPIs for January came in better than expected, they still stayed below the Bank of Canada's inflation aim of 2%. Thus, with all that in mind, we don't believe that tapering may be on the cards in the months to come, especially if the GDP has slowed as the forecast suggests in December. Now, as for the rest of today's events, apart from Eurozone's inflation data and Canada's GDP, we also get Germany's unemployment rate for February, which is forecast to have held steady at 6%, as well as the American Petroleum Institute report on crude oil inventories for last week, for which no forecast is available. Tonight, during the Asian session Wednesday, Australia's GDP for the fourth quarter is due to be released. The quarter-over-quarter rate is expected to have declined to 2.5% from 3.3%, but the year-over-year one is anticipated to have increased to -1.8% from -3.8%. China's Caixin Services PMI for February is also coming out, but no forecast is available. We also have four speakers on the schedule: ECB Executive Board Member Fabio Panetta, ECB Supervisory Board Member Elizabeth McCall, San Francisco Fed President Mary Daly, and Fed Board Governor Lael Brainard. So that's it from me. Thank you very much for watching and listening. For those who are interested in learning about the main events of the week much earlier, you can subscribe to the weekly Market Outlook webinar, which I'm holding every Monday at 8 o'clock AM GMT. You can find the link in the description below. So goodbye, have a great day, and I'm looking forward to seeing you here again tomorrow.
JFT, just fair and direct.